What's up, guys? My name's Brandon, and today Apple released iPadOS 13.4 for all iPads compatible with iOS or iPadOS 13. And while we were not expecting too much from this update at first, it turns out that this is actually a massive update, and in this video, I'm going to explain why. So we're going to be covering what's new in iPadOS 13.4, including the all-new mouse and trackpad support, custom keyboard shortcuts, the performance and battery life, and much, much more. And taking a look at the size of this update, you can see here on my 2019 iPad 10.2, it came in at just about 1 gigabyte, 1.05 gigs, and that was coming from 13.3.1. So the size will hover around 1 gigabyte, but of course it will depend on your device and what firmware you came from. Now, as far as the build number, if you go to settings, general, about, you can see there the build number is the same as iOS. We have 17E255. So let's go ahead and talk about what's new here in iPadOS 13.4, because this is absolutely game changing for the iPad, and it's going to change the way you use your iPad from here on out. And the reason for that is because now mouse support is no longer just an accessibility feature. iPadOS 13.4 introduces true mouse and trackpad support. So I have a Magic Trackpad 2 here, and I will be showing you all the new gestures that come with the trackpad in iPadOS 13.4. But for now, I'm gonna be showing you with an actual mouse. And for this, I'm gonna be using the Logitech Performance mouse, but of course this will work for any Bluetooth or USB mouse. This one's actually USB, so I have a USB-C to USB-A connector right here that I'm just gonna plug into the bottom of my iPad. So once you hook up your USB, or if you connect via Bluetooth, once you do that, you will see the mouse comes up right away right here, and you can instantly tell that it's a little bit different. So you can see when you go over top of applications, it changes dynamically. It basically shows you that you're hovering over something that you can change, which is really, really nice. And if you're inside your settings or inside an application, if you just take the mouse down to the bottom, you can see it pulls up the dock just like so, and if you pull it up, it goes away. It's very, very responsive. And if you want to get back to the home screen very easily, you just click on the home bar right there and it takes you right back home. Now you can also click on other things like the battery. So when you click on the battery, you can see it pulls up the control center. Just click off of it to get off. And if you're in portrait mode and you have the time in the upper left-hand corner of the status bar, if you click on that, it will bring down notification center. But if you're in landscape mode, you just simply drag from the far left and will pull up your notification center like so. And then you can just tap on the home bar down here and that will go away and take you back to the home screen. Now I mentioned that you can click on the home bar to go back home, but there's actually multiple other ways to go home. So you can also take the cursor right here and just bring it all the way down. Once it pulls up the dock, keep dragging down and it will take you to the home screen. And if you drag a little bit further, it will pull up the multitasking view. So there are multiple like gestures hidden inside of other gestures with not only the Magic Trackpad, but also with the mouse here. Now you can also click to wake the iPad as well. So if you click, it will go ahead and wake the iPad. And of course it will look for your face for Face ID. And that can make that whole process a little bit easier, so you don't actually have to touch your iPad if you don't want to. And the cool thing about this too, is you'll notice that the cursor will disappear here. If you don't use it for a little while, it will disappear. And then you can just use your fingers to control your iPad like you do when you don't have a cursor. So there it goes, it disappeared. And you can just use it. Of course, you can use it when it's still on there as well, but it's nice that it disappears. And actually, if we go into our settings right here, and then you will see we have a new section here called trackpad and mouse. If you go and click on that, you can see you can change your tracking speed right here. You can choose natural or not natural scrolling. So if you like it to be, you know, when you go down, it goes down, you can have that selected. I don't like natural scrolling on, so I turn that off. You also have your secondary click right here, so you can right click and pull up things like the 3D touch menu. So if we go back here and right click, you can see it brings up our 3D touch menu like so. The right click also really helps when you're doing text editing and just typing and things like that. It just makes life so much easier. So now let's bring in the Magic Trackpad 2, and I'm gonna show you guys some of the cool new gestures available with 13.4. So let's go ahead and turn this on, and it should connect right away to my iPad since I already had it paired before. But if not, let's go into our settings and then go to Bluetooth. And then you can see right here, Magic Trackpad 2, and it will connect just like so. And so the Magic Trackpad acts just like the mouse did, except we have multiple other gestures that we could do with the Magic Trackpad and only the Magic Trackpad. So the first gesture I'm gonna show you guys is yet another way to go home, and that's a 3-finger swipe up just like so, and you can see it takes you home just like that. Now, just like when you took the cursor and brought it down, if you do the 3 fingers up and keep going up, it will bring up the multitasking view like that. Now, if you use those fingers and swipe left or right, you will jump in between applications just like so. It makes multitasking very, very easy and going in and out of applications a lot more convenient than if you just use your finger or a mouse. Now also, if we go into our Safari right here, we do also have some gestures that we can use inside of Safari. So if we take two fingers, you can go back and forward like so. So back and forward to the previous or the page you went to before that. It's really convenient for just getting around and going back to the web page you were just at. I also found it much easier to just navigate around websites with the nav bars with drop downs like this than using your finger. It's just so much more convenient and so much more like an actual desktop or laptop experience when you can actually go through the menus very easily, like I'm doing here with the trackpad. Another huge benefit to having something like the Magic Trackpad 2 is with something like LumaFusion or GarageBand or wherever you have like a timeline where you're editing audio or editing video or even editing photos, this could come in handy as well. So if we go ahead and do this right here, and I'm just gonna add in a blank clip right here. And by the way, I love just being able to use my finger when I want and my mouse when I want. But anyways, the thing I like about 13.4 is that you can actually now skim back and forth throughout the clip like so, or you can use two fingers to pinch and zoom or zoom out just like so. It's very much like the touch bar on the MacBook. You can really control projects really easily with 13.4 and the true mouse and trackpad support. Now, since we have the trackpad connected, we can also go into settings and see some new options in there as well. So if we go to our settings, go to general, and then go to trackpad, you can see we do have a couple of different ones right here. We have tap to click, and that's actually the only other one. We have two finger secondary click there as well. So you can enable these if you want to. You can also, of course, change the tracking speed. And of course, you have natural scrolling, which I have disabled. Now, also, if we go to our settings and go to accessibility and then go down to pointer control, you can see we have some new options in here as well. So we have the automatically hide pointer. You can change the setting, the duration on this in terms of seconds. I like the 2 second default setting. We also have color. So if you wanted it to be easier to see, you can change it to something like blue or green or yellow. Could be a little bit easier to see on the screen, especially for you guys watching this video. You could also change the pointer size. If you want it bigger or smaller, you could do so. I like mine being as small as possible. You can also change the animation. So if we go ahead and hover over accessibility, you see it has that animation there. If you wanted to turn that off, you can. And then it just has this really subtle gray background over top of it instead. But I like to have the animations on. I think it looks better. It makes it look a lot more dynamic and like it's actually meant to be used this way. You also have trackpad inertia right here, which allows the pointer to continue moving after you lift your finger. I would highly recommend having this enabled. You also have your scrolling speed right here. I'll probably up this just a little bit, but you can change all these settings now inside of your accessibility settings. And I just think that the support for this is going to get just so much better as third-party applications, you know, pick up on this and you know, adjust their applications to work better with trackpad and mice now that they are actually truly supported in iPadOS, and it's not just, you know, an accessibility feature that you have to dig through the settings to get to. Now, iPadOS 13.4 also introduces full keyboard access if you have a smart keyboard. So if you go into our settings and go to accessibility and then down to keyboards, you can see you have this option right here, full keyboard access. If you turn that on, you can go ahead and have full keyboard access where you can basically control your entire iPad from the keyboard alone. You won't need to touch it. You won't need a mouse or a trackpad. You can control everything from the tab keys, the arrow keys, and things like that. Now, what's really cool is this section right here called Command. So this will allow you to have custom keyboard shortcuts on your iPad. So once again, this is becoming even more and more like a Mac. This is like literally Mac OS now. So you can have custom keyboard shortcuts for pretty much everything. As you can see here, tons of different commands you can set up, and the fact that you can control your whole iPad with the keyboard, I mean, this is just nuts. So I don't have a Magic Keyboard right now, but I will be getting one, and I may show this in a future video as well. But if you do have a keyboard, definitely go ahead and check this out and set up some custom commands. You will absolutely love it. So these are just absolutely huge features, especially for a 0.4 release. This is something you would expect to see in like iOS 14 or something like that, or iOS 13, but no, it's in 13.4. So this makes me even more excited for iOS 14, honestly. But anyways, let's move on to some of the other smaller changes in iPadOS 13.4. Now, if you watched my iOS 13.4 video, you've probably already seen most of these features, but I am still going to quickly cover them because they are also in iPadOS 13.4. So the first thing, of course, is going to be iCloud folder sharing. So if we go to this folder right here and right click or two finger click to pull up the contextual menu right here, you can see we have share, and we have share. You also have add people. So this is where you can add people as like collaborators if you want people to add things to a folder or be able to edit them, or you could also have permissions so that that person can maybe only view only. And you can see these different settings you have right here that you could change, which are really nice. And this is really making files, the files application, more of a competitor to things like Dropbox and Google Drive. Now, also inside of the mail application, we not only get a lot of bug fixes, so there were a lot of bugs in 13.3 and 13.3.1. We got a lot of bug fixes, but we also, as you can see from the toolbars right here, we have everything available to us to see at once. We have our reply, our compose, our delete, our folders, everything is just available at once instead of being hidden and having to go into these menus to get to certain things. It's all right here right now. And you can see here, flag is a lot easier to flag and unflag now than it was in iPadOS 13.3.1. Just a lot of improvements to the mail application that may seem small on the outside, but once you continue using it, you will see that mail is just a lot more stable and easier to use than it was in previous versions. Now also, if we go into the TV application, we have some changes in here. So over on the left-hand side, you can see we have a whole new section now for genres, instead of just having to go to TV shows and sort by the genre up in the top right. That's all available to you right there in that submenu on the left-hand side. And if we go into our settings and go to TV down here, you can see we have some new changes here as well. So we have the Wi-Fi streaming options. You could change that from high quality or data saver. You also have your download options for Wi-Fi and cellular if you have a cellular version of the iPad as well. And then the device preferences are bundled together now instead of being spread out. You also have your video definition for your purchases there as well. So just some minor improvements to the TV application and the TV settings. There's also 9 new Memoji stickers. So if you use Memojis in iMessage or wherever you want to use them, there are now 9 new ones to express how you're feeling towards something. And that's pretty much it for the main changes in iPadOS 13.4. I covered some of the smaller ones in my iOS 13.4 video. So if you want to watch that, I will leave it linked down in the description below. But as far as the bug fixes, there were also a lot of bug fixes in iPadOS 13.4. I mentioned mail earlier, but Apple also included all of these as bug fixes for iPadOS 13.4. I'm not going to cover every single one of them, but we can read a few of them here and just briefly cover them. So this one right here, it says addresses an issue in Safari where web pages may not be inverted when both dark mode and smart invert are active. So I had somebody mention that to me on social media on 13.3 on their iPad specifically. So you can see there that has been fixed. And we have all these other ones right here with iCloud Drive, Safari, issues in the home application, Apple Music, where music videos may not stream in high quality, fixes an issue where iCloud Drive appears to be available in Pages, Numbers, and Keynote even when not signed in, fixes an issue in Safari where a captcha tile may display incorrectly. So just a lot of really minor things that most people probably have not run into, at least not all of these, but they are fixes that you should be aware about and are just another reason that you should definitely upgrade to 13.4 as soon as you can, just because this is a huge update and it's also very stable, which I'll talk about here in the performance section of this video. Now, I should also mention how much more convenient iPadOS 13.4 makes typing and selecting text, highlighting text, anything to do with text editing is so much more convenient and fluid, just so much better on 13.4. You can get in and out of things. You can double tap to select a word like that. And it's just very easy to drag, you know, things like this. You can pull it over. You can put the text somewhere else, just like so. Just so easy and just really awesome, especially compared to iPadOS 13.3.1. It really feels like you're using a MacBook when you have a Magic Trackpad 2 here paired with 13.4. Now, as far as performance goes, iPadOS 13.4 is super, super solid. It's probably the most stable version of iOS I've seen yet. And that's really saying something, given the fact that we got all these new features introduced. Everything runs super smooth, super fast. Of course, I am using the iPad Pro, but I also use the budget iPad 10.2 here, and everything performs super, super well. Games, web browsing, video watching, you name it, performance is very solid on this update. It is definitely more stable than 13.3.1. And if you're coming from an even earlier version of iOS 13 or iPadOS 13, you're gonna notice an even bigger difference in terms of performance. And as far as battery life goes, battery life is probably gonna be about the same as 13.3.1. I've not really noticed a huge difference so far in iPadOS 13.4, but honestly, that's a good thing. Like I said, all the new features added and everything like that, it's a good thing that the battery life has not decreased. So I think it's increased, but we will be able to tell in about a week when I bring you guys my follow-up video. I will let you guys know how much better battery life is. It is a little bit harder to gauge on the iPad Pro though, or the iPad in general, just because I don't have to charge it every single night like I do my iPhone. So it's a little bit harder to judge, but I will give you guys an update next week in my follow-up video. So now, should you update to iPadOS 13.4? And to that, It should be a no-brainer. Absolutely. You should definitely upgrade to iPadOS 13.4. The new true mouse and trackpad support is quite literally a game changer. I mean, the iPad is now closer than ever to a laptop replacement. It makes me even more excited to see what iOS 14 brings in a couple of months. But the fact that all this came in a 13.4 update is just crazy. I mean, it was very unexpected. It's probably because the new iPad Pro is coming out with a new Magic Keyboard, which I will be getting in May. But the fact that this is also brought to all the older iPads as well, even without that Magic Trackpad, is just awesome. So yeah, if you have not updated to iPadOS 13.4 yet, go ahead and do so ASAP, because you will absolutely love this update, especially if you have a Magic Trackpad, a keyboard, or a mouse in general, really anything to take advantage of these new gestures and the new true mouse and trackpad support. But anyways, guys, if you enjoyed this video, I would appreciate it if you gave it a thumbs up, and of course, subscribe so you don't miss my follow-up video on iPadOS 13.4 coming next week, where I'll touch on the battery life and performance and things like that, things I've noticed over a week of using it. And of course, stay tuned, because tomorrow I will be unboxing the brand new 2020 iPad Pro and comparing it to the 2018 here as well. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.